give Dr. Abhay Shukla a big hand of applause and express our thanks, our appreciation for a highly educative, enlightening talk. You know, he said that ORF could organize this in just a few days' time, but actually we should thank him for accepting to give a talk here at such short notice. It was an impossibly short notice. He was coming here for some other purpose, and we just dragged him here. And I really hope that this is not the first time that we're going to see you at ORF with a person of such knowledge, experience, commitment, dedication. We need your guidance, and we wish to work closely with you and your organization and contribute in our own way. And thank you all who participated in this program. As my colleague Radha said, many of you are newcomers to ORF. Keep coming. Dr. Shukla made a very important point right at the beginning. It's self-evident, but nevertheless, it needs to be stated again and again, understood, that the private sector is an unregulated giant. It's a giant in the overall healthcare space. But healthcare activists have so far been focusing their attention, their activism on the public healthcare services, public healthcare system, how to improve it. Of course, that's important, but as he rightly pointed out, organizations like ours, organizations that have been active in healthcare space, have so far devoted disproportionate attention to the public healthcare system and avoided, neglected the private healthcare system, which is truly a giant. And as he again rightly said, this probably comes out of our, you know, a sense of hopelessness, that we can't do anything to change the private sector. Public sector, it represents government, so we can demand changes, we can demand reforms, but private sector seems to be outside the pale of democracy. So I would say that the thrust of what he said is that politics and democracy must stand for what he called the social logic and not the profit logic. If healthcare system in India is to change, is to serve the people, then the private sector must be brought within the overall logic of regulation, social regulation. And therefore, we really should congratulate you, your organization, and all the network organizations which have made private healthcare sector regulation a frontline agenda. But Dr. Shukla made another very important point, which I think the significance of which goes far beyond the discussion on healthcare. There was one slide: social regulation equals state regulation, participatory monitoring by citizens, plus professional self-regulation. And all this through multi-stakeholder bodies at various levels. I think this is really encapsulating the whole philosophy, of participatory democracy, making democracy serve the people with people's participation. All these decades after independence, regulation has meant regulation by bureaucrats and disempowerment of the people, including the various people's stakeholders. And this is true not only in the case of healthcare, education, again, the key stakeholders, be it students or parents, they don't have rights, or those rights are not enforced. Be it housing, the key stakeholders, people, they are shortchanged. So, you know, we can go on and on. What is happening is that the state has come to mean bureaucracy and political representatives, and as has been rightly said, political representatives, elected representatives, don't really represent the people. Democracy is not just voting once in 5 years, which is what it has been reduced to. And therefore, what Dr. Shukla said tells us that there's a need to democratize our democracy, make it truly participative, empower the people. Now, I would like to make a few suggestions and also express some commitments on behalf of our organization as far as going forward to first ensure that we stall the adoption of the National Act for Maharashtra, and thereafter to urge the people's representatives in Maharashtra to make suitable and proper modifications in the bill, in the act, and then introduce a bill, make a truly progressive law for Maharashtra, which can then be adopted, or which can then at least be seen as a template by other states. So first, I feel that the next 2 months are very critical, and all of us here, we should think of reaching out our voice, our demands to people's representatives. MLAs, all the MLAs, all the MPs, leaders of political parties, and others who matter in the political and governance space. ORF, of course, will write immediately based on all that we have learned. And we would also like to have any draft bill that you have prepared. We would certainly write to the Chief Minister, the Health Minister, with whom we've had some interaction on other healthcare matters, and of course, leaders of other political parties. But we would urge friends, you know, you representatives of different organizations. I'm very happy that we have a very influential organization present here, Praja, which, you know, quite regularly, you know, shakes the system with its reports. And of course, there are other organizations, you know, including the Association of Medical Consultants, you know, with whom we've had some interaction, and we learned that even the professionals have very legitimate grievances which the bureaucracy, you know, doesn't address. You know, the problems of nursing home owners. You know, you are a very unique person. You represent both the Association of Medical Consultants and you're also an additional municipal commissioner. You know, it was really surprising for us to know that these highly established medical professionals, so afraid of bureaucrats, and they said, therefore they came to us, that we can't even get an appointment with the CM and others, so can you please be the intermediary. And there are 8,000 members in Mumbai alone, Mumbai and... It's not a small number. So, this is important. Therefore, all these stakeholder organizations should also write. And if you got some 55 prominent doctors, you know, to write a letter, please give a copy of that letter. You know, we will try to mobilize as many doctors and other people associated with the healthcare system to write letters. We certainly should, amongst all these things, we should also think of having a morcha. It is important not just to meet elected representatives privately, but keep on publicly expressing our views, and we will try to make it a little more effective. We need to involve the media again in a big way. I'm sorry that in spite of our efforts, you know, we usually have some sympathetic, committed media professionals, but let's make this a point of debate with a certain sense of urgency. And if we all work together, expand our network, I'm sure that we can make some difference. And once again, Shuklaji, we thank you for stimulating our thought process in this direction with your truly enlightening talk. We have learnt a lot, and we would like to work closely with you in the time to come. Dhanyavad.